You know what I'm saying? Today, bro. Wait, hold on. You know what? What's good, YouTube? Today, this video is going to be very different. Today, I'm going to tell y'all the worst trading mistakes that traders make and shit. Really? That I make. You know what I'm saying? I am a trader. I do this shit every day. If you can relate to me, you'll probably find something good out this damn video. The first one, FOMO. Fear of missing out. They be like, what's FOMO? What's fear of missing out? Alright, so you see y'all get some shit on the news like Shiba Inu, if y'all know that, that's crypto or Bitcoin. They be like, buy this, buy that, buy this, buy that. Don't buy this, buy that. Don't do that shit. That's fear of missing out. Everybody else making money, you trying to make some money off of it, but you never do. You really never do. It's too late. Once you hear it on the news, it's too late, man. I'm mad as fuck, dog. I lost a lot of money, y'all. Second trading mistake I be seeing a lot of people use, including me, being impatient. Now, if I would have held like all my calls through, like collected all my full profit instead of just seeing $500 and pulling out, bro, I would have been up so much. Because like one thing I realized is I let my L's run longer than my wins. Y'all need to fix that shit. Do never ever let your losses go longer than your wins. When your alerts go off, pull the fuck out. Number three, you need to be aware of these damn market conditions. We in a recession right now. So for the most part, ain't shit going up, no toss. So you need to be looking to place puts. Now we within a good economy where everything going good. Got the Apple stock and all that shit going up. You wanna do calls. But right now, we're in a recession. So what I mean by you need to know the current market conditions. You need to know what the fuck going on before you enter a trade. Cause, you know what I'm saying? If we in a recession, yeah, the RSI and all that shit might be going down. Like the RSI might be reset all the way at the bottom. You look for calls. But if it was all the way at the top and you would've did put options, you would've made more money. Because like right now in a recession, you'll see a stock drop 20% before you see the shit go up 5%. So, you know what I'm saying? You know your current market conditions. You need to just use common fucking sense. Like, straight up. And another thing, like I said earlier, be patient. Another trading mistake I be doing is I be getting out the market too damn soon. Like, if I would've stayed in the market long enough to collect full profit on my trades, I wouldn't even be tripping about that little $5,000 loss. Cause that shit wouldn't be nothing to me. Don't change your strategy. This is why I fucked up. This is why I'm gonna show y'all a little example. Alright, so you know my strategy. My strategy always works. But I'm gonna be honest, it ain't work this time. I'm gonna show you exactly what the fuck I did. Alright, so damn yesterday, man. Yesterday fucking day. Yesterday, right here. I was hurt. This looks like a pretty good chart, right? You know what I'm saying? Right here. This is just a 15 minute. Just a 15 minute. I know. That's why I say it. You know, just 15 minute. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, oh shit. Shit at the bottom. Okay. The RSI at the bottom. It's finna go up. I got here like, let me do some calls. Look. The RSI 15 minute even goes up. It goes up right here. I should have pulled out, but I didn't. I had my alert set it for right here. Right here. So you know what I'm saying? I was like, you know what? It's gonna go up. You know what I'm saying? The 15 minute RSI, it's gonna always go up. So you know what I'm saying? I waited and it just kept going down. And I don't know why I didn't pull out. I saw my shit going down like 500, 700. I dead ass don't know why it was going down. Me, I was thinking in my head, all this shit going up, it's gonna just fly back up to like 63, but fuck no, I ain't do none of that shit. See, as the RSI says it's going up on the indicators, the price still going down. That's why I say you need to know current market conditions. If you don't, that shit gonna fuck you up. That shit gonna fuck you over. Just like how it did me. And I'm gonna be honest, this is a midterm election. So it is other market conditions that came into play that I should have knew. Like yesterday, Bitcoin, man, look at this shit. Let me show y'all what Bitcoin did. This is another thing that I say I should have known that came into play. For the last 2 days, Bitcoin dropped 9% one day and 14% yesterday. That's another reason why I lost my trade. The stock market and the crypto market so heavily influenced together, bro. Should be blowing the fuck out of me. But you know what I'm saying? Let me just recap so I can tell y'all so y'all don't ever fuck up. I'm gonna read this shit to y'all. FOMO, fear of missing out. If you hear about a trade, like off on YouTube or the news, don't enter. If it's not like a damn private investor with like a Discord or Twitter or damn Instagram, he talk to you word for word, bro. Fear of missing out, don't do that shit. Don't enter the trade. Being impatient. Be patient, especially if the trade going your way. I don't give a fuck, dog. Smoke a blunt and chill the fuck out. If you got to smoke a blunt, sleep on it. You can do that, because that's what I did before. I slept on it, woke up 300, you know what I'm saying, for real. Be aware of the market conditions. We're in a recession. Watch for calls. Don't do calls. Do puts. So watch for puts. Then, what the fuck else I was going to say? Oh, yeah, don't change your strategy too much. Once you find out that one of your alerts got hit, pull out, whether it's going up or down. That's the thing, you need to put your alerts on your support and resistance and just let that bitch ride. You know what I'm saying? But you know what I'm saying? It's your boy K2 Analytics. The way out of this bitch, like, subscribe, and I'm out. I'm trying this shit. Man, YouTube, look at this shit, man. I spoke way too soon. That's why I told y'all boys, I gotta be patient in the goddamn market cash. You can fucking see. I pulled out yesterday, and literally, before the market even opened, it had a dead cat bounce at 7 a.m. because I didn't know about the market conditions. There was a CPI this morning, and it was positive. And you see how my AMD stock went up damn near 11%? Yeah, I would have made all my money plus more. So yeah, be patient in the market. I done lost 80% of my bread. I'm about to stop scalping. God damn.